In this video, I'll be showing you the best Valorant color settings for visibility. To start, head to the settings and go to General. Find the accessibility options, then set enemy highlight color to yellow or red. I find it easier to notice a yellow outline on enemies, but you may prefer red. Go to the video settings and select graphics quality. Go down and turn off the improved clarity setting. Although this can make Valorant look a bit nicer, it's not worth the FPS trade-off. Turn on experimental sharpening. Then turn on bloom if you want to make your skins look a bit better. However, I don't recommend it. Right-click on the desktop, then go to Show More Options and open the NVIDIA control panel. If you don't have an NVIDIA graphics card, then go to the timestamp on screen. Select Adjust Desktop Color Settings from the side. Then select the monitor you use for Valorant. Before adjusting any settings, I recommend opening up a screenshot or a few screenshots from Valorant to ensure you get the best settings for your monitor. And also consider writing down your current settings just in case. We tested settings on a few different monitors and came up with three color setting options that should work for most people. For option one, set the color channel to all, then set brightness to 52, contrast to 50, gamma to 1.10, digital vibrance to 70, and hue to 0. For option 2, set color channel to all channels, brightness to 57, contrast to 42, gamma to 1.0, digital vibrance to 80, and hue to 0. And for option 3, set color channel to all channels, brightness to 55, contrast to 55, gamma to 1.20, digital vibrance to 85, and hue to 0. If Valorant looks washed out or flat, then try decreasing the brightness or gamma to fix the issue. Apply settings when you're happy. Keep in mind, this will change how your monitor looks at all times. Another option is to use Vibrance GUI, which will only apply the color changes when Valorant is open. Head to the Vibrance GUI website. The link is included in the description. Download the appropriate version for your system, then open the file location. Right-click on the file and select Extract All. Choose where you want the file to save to, then choose to extract. Open the extracted folder, then launch Vibrance GUI. Turn on Auto Start Vibrance GUI to have it launch whenever you turn your PC on. If you have Valorant open, then click Add and double-click on Valorant to select it. Otherwise, click Add manually. Navigate to the Valorant installation folder. It is typically located in the Riot Games folder in C Drive. Go to Live, Shooter Game, Binaries, then Win64. Scroll down and select the Valorant Win64 shipping application, then click Open. Set the in-game vibrance level. I tend to use about 70, but you may prefer 80 or 85. Save, and Vibrance GUI will automatically make Valorant more colorful when the game is open. Similarly, Razer Cortex will only make color changes when Valorant is open. The link will also be included in the description. Open Razer Cortex once it's been installed. Go to Game Booster, then Booster Prime. Select Valorant, then click Make Adjustments on the image. Turn on the Make Adjustments option in the top right. Set digital vibrance between 70 and 85 using the example images as a guide. Save changes. Another highly underutilized feature are the color settings on your monitor. Most monitors have some sort of color settings which you can take advantage of. If you have a BenQ monitor, then you can use the black equalizer setting to increase visibility in dark areas. Otherwise, your screen may have a black stabilizer setting, which is similar. Some people may also find it beneficial to play with a subtle blue temperature on their screen, as it can help counter some of the harsher colors in Valorant. If your screen has a sharpness or sharpening setting, then increasing it slightly can also help with visibility. Like the video if you found it helpful, and check out the video here for the best Valorant settings.